वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज एक्सपर्ट लेक्चर सीरीज 2020-21 एंड इट इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय द सेंट्रल कोऑर्डिनेशन कमिटी ऑफ द गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटी. विल बी डीलिंग विद द इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट. आई एम मिस्टर प्रवीण मुळे फ्रॉम द बीवाईके कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स नासिक. एंड specifying the objectives for this particular expert lecture series as far as English subject is concerned. Our first and foremost objective is to help and prepare students of class 12 to prepare themselves to appear for the HSC examination. We'll be providing and facilitating all the important tips, essentials and very important requirements necessary for the board examination and to acquire enough confidence by identifying areas that student need more focus. And this particular online YouTube facility is basically to bridge the gap between the student and the teacher to win over this unavoidable crisis of this pandemic effect. And therefore, this is the plan. Let us focus on the present conditions. First and foremost, we have to understand, where do I stand in these conditions? How much have I understood? What is left out? And what has been studied till now? What is remaining? And how I am going to deal with all this remaining pending work? Which areas in each subject do I need special focus, extra care and more practice? This we have to focus. This is one of the important conditions of today. How can I score more in each subject? Have I made a list of doubts in each subject that can be clarified? So, doubts are very important. Unless and until you go through your study material, you will not find any doubts. And how should I plan my study in the leftover span? So in the remaining 2 months, 2 or 3 months, there are maybe not more than 2 months you have in hand, where you can plan your study and how you are going to go about it. So these are the present conditions. As far as the compulsory English for 80 marks is concerned, as it is a new textbook, all the students of class 12th are going to face the new pattern and they are going to appear for this particular examination for the new pattern for the first time. And therefore, the comprehensive competencies, what sort of competencies are required, what sort of pattern they are going to face, it should be very, very clear. And this textbook has not only language aspects, but it also has literary aspects. So focus should be also on the literary aspects as well. There are addition of new writing skills which need to be focused more and more. Then the syllabus frame to develop English language learning skills for students' future aspirations. So this textbook is also going to help students in their future studies also. And 25% of the portion is removed from the syllabus, and therefore this year some topics from the course book, from the textbook, will not be asked in the examination. And therefore we have also the oral process which has a new pattern altogether. This video has been prepared and it is an attempt for the students to deal with so many other aspects of English subject for the board examination. And I will also suggest that please go through the links that I have provided in the information below, which will help you to go through different videos that I have prepared and which will help you to acquire confidence in the other areas of compulsory English also. Now what? It is a basic question. How will I practically succeed in achieving maximum marks in English? Though English is not taken seriously by the English medium students, we have always seen that the Marathi medium students have always scored more and more marks. Therefore, overconfidence is dangerous. How should I plan my studies accordingly? How will I know the exact area of focus in the HSC board examination? What will be my exact direction towards achieving maximum confidence to face the English language paper? How will you go about it? Therefore, all our doubts, all our preparation, all our areas are focused on three important aspects that you have to prepare. You have to plan properly. Planning is important. Planning, after planning, you have to prepare for those areas, prepare in those areas which you have problems, and then actually presenting your answers in the answer paper. This is presentation. So planning, preparation and presentation are the three important aspects that you will deal with as far as English paper is concerned. Now you have to prove that you are ready. These aspects are going to help you. You have to prove that you are ready with all those things. You have to prove that you have potential in yourself. You can build up your own self by rising up. If you have not done anything till now, still there is time. So no worries. To prove your credibility, you have inner skills, you have good skills, you have potentials. So that particular credibility can be proved. To prove that you are confident. And last but not least is to prove that you can definitely do it. Definitely do it. So planning, preparation and presentation are the important aspects. And therefore, we wish you all the best. And let us continue with the very important aspects of English paper. The board English paper, the important areas will be focused in this video. Let us continue with it. As already notified earlier, there are some topics which are not in the portion, which are supposed to be not studied by the students of class 12th as far as English subject is concerned. So here we have four topics which are not in the portion only for this year. There are two lessons from the prose section and two poems from the poetry section. 1.5, that is the new dress. 1.7, why we travel. These two lessons are not for study. They are not in the portion. So students will not study this. And again, two poems, 2.7 and 2.8, they are not in the portion. She walks in beauty in small towns and rivers, which students will, of course, not study. We also know that the textbook, that is the English textbook, is divided into four sections: the prose, poetry, writing skills, the novel, and novel as a genre. And the activity sheet, which is given for 80 marks, and the marks with options are 112. So the largest number of marks are allotted for the prose section. Then the poetry section has 14 marks, writing skills are 16, and with options there are 48. So this is only the area where you have options at the writing skills place, that is the third section, and novel for 16 marks. So we are going to see all the details one by one. Let us move to the first section, that is the prose. The prose section is titled as the reading for comprehension, language study, summary writing and mind mapping. So these two are writing skills here, but especially in the prose section. Let us see the objectives. Why do we actually have, or what actually we do have, we have in this activity sheet, that is the question paper, what we call as, and actually in English and languages we call as activity sheet. We test students in different skills. We test students in section 1, as far as prose is concerned, in reading activities, especially skimming and scanning. Skimming is just reading it very fast, and scanning is going into the details of the text that you actually read. Then we test the thinking skills. The thinking skills are further divided into lots, that is lower order thinking skills, and also we have MOTS, that is middle order thinking skills, and we have HOTS, higher order thinking skills. So all these thinking skills, which we call as creativity, and then further it is called as constructivism, and all these skills are tested in prose section, and therefore we have students which the text which helps them to remember, to understand, to apply, to analyze, to evaluate, and to create new things, and which are nothing but the HOTS, which are the higher order thinking skills. So thinking is made more effective in this section, prose section, and therefore this area has such activities for 34 marks. We'll see the details. As far as the title is concerned, this section is, or it consists of comprehension passage. It has language study. Language study is divided into three categories. Language study means grammar. It means vocabulary. And it means different type of activities on grammar. So let us start to the first, by the first question. Question worst A is titled the read the extract and complete the activities given below. It is for 12 marks. And we see that there are so many activities in this question. So first of all, a scene extract will be given from the prose section. And then you will have to solve or write the activities in all this A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. Each activity is for 2 marks. Right, starting from the global understanding type of activity, then the complex factual, inference, interpretation, analysis. Then we have personal response. Then we have language study, vocabulary. Now all these type of activities are for 2 marks. And we are going to go into details of each one. What is actually this? What is global? What is complex? And once you understand this, I think it is certainly going to help you to write the answer or complete the activity properly. Let us call each one as an activity and not as a question, because as it is called as an activity sheet, we have activities and slightly different in the last question of the activity sheet, which is slightly different. So question 1A is for 12 marks total. One by one we'll see. As far as the activity on global understanding is concerned, there will be many activities which will be based on all this. Now, what is global understanding? Global understanding is understanding of the whole passage, whole extract from the textbook, which means it expects a message from you, or it may expect a theme, or it may expect a gist. Gist is the central idea. And the activities based on this can be true or false activities. Correct the statements, correct the reasons, complete the following, fill in the blank, sequencing, etc. And there can be many other such activities which are based on the overall understanding of the extract. Complex factual type of activity, which means that the facts in the whole passage are scattered in the extract. They are scattered. You have to find out, maybe they will ask you to sequence, and many other things. Now, this complex factual activity can be based on a web diagram, web chart, or flow chart, complete the table, match the pairs, or match anything that is required, complete the sentences or statements, or complete the following. And maybe they will ask you to select alternative statements, alternatives which are based on the facts in the complex factual type of question, and which are scattered in the whole passage, which is for 2 marks. Now, activities on 2 marks are to be written in the answer sheet as expected. For example, if there is a web chart, if there is a flow chart, if there is complete the table, students will have to completely draw the table or the flow chart and all the things that are given, and just don't write only the answers. So complete the whole thing that is given in the question paper. So not only words are expected, but the whole charts, diagrams are supposed to be drawn by the students in the activity sheet. The third type of activity in question number 1A is inference type or interpretation type or analysis type. Now, what is all this? Let's one by one we'll see. Inference is drawing an inference from whatever is given. That is deduce, guess, infer. Understanding, guessing the meaning, or to take out the meaning according to the text. Now, as far as inferential type of activity is concerned, it is nothing but you have to understand and draw something out of the given text. Inference. Interpret. By interpretation, we means we have to understand or come to know after reading that particular activity. Once you read it, you'll try to, you have to interpret the idea by your own and what actually you have understood as far as the meaning of that particular activity is concerned. Analyze or analysis. Now, the details, study from all angles of the passage. Maybe you have to divide it into parts or you have to dissect the parts. Again, this particular activity can be asked in the form of a web or a flow chart or complete the table, match the pairs, etc., etc. Let us move forward. The personal response, this is a very famous type of questions where you have to express your own views, opinions, ideas, similar situations by imagining a particular idea in your own mind and putting responses, putting your own opinion, ideas about the same in your own words, in your own sentences. So this is also for 2 marks. See all this. Maybe this activity will be based on your self-experience, same type of experience which you have already experienced, but it's a parallel one. Expressing views, opinions, ideas, reaction, response. I agree or do you disagree to certain things? Maybe they'll ask you to put your own suggestions, your solutions. Maybe they'll ask you to put your own remedy, measure, steps, draw conclusions, give reason, influence, impact, effect, comment, criticize, etc. So there are so many types of activities that can be asked. Now, this particular topic or this particular activity in the personal response will wholly depend on the original title or original subject of the passage or subject of the original passage. A5 is language study. It's for 2 marks. Now here we have textual grammar extract, which is from the textbook, which is from the scene passage. 2 activities for 1 mark each. Now this can be based on do as director or transformation. So they'll ask you to change the sentence from the point of view of the paper setter. Vocabulary, 2 activities for 1 mark. There are so many types of activities here. They can ask you a word registered, maybe a concept from the whole passage, a word for many words, meaning a crossword puzzle, word puzzle, riddle, fill in the blanks, find a word from the passage which means something, match the pairs, for example. Maybe it can be word meaning or synonym antonyms or word formation, etc. So vocabulary, testing vocabulary. So the whole thing B part, the whole thing ends here after the B part. That is a question 1A and B, which is language study and which is not from the passage and which is not from the text. It is non-textual grammar for 4 marks, where do as directed and transformation of sentence is asked in the B1 part. So they may give you 3 sentences to change any of the do as directed activity. This is also activity based, and spot the error. Now, while spotting the error, you have to, maybe they'll ask you to correct the sentence, find the error in the sentence, find error in the punctuation, find jumbled sentences, or identify the correct sentence. There can be any error in the sentence, and they will ask you to spot the error. So it is for 1 mark. And in this way, question 1, A plus B, that is 12 plus 4, we have for 16 marks. Let us move on to the second question of the prose section. Section 1, prose. Now, this particular question is for 18 marks in all, but question 2A, we have an unseen passage. The type of questions are the same, and question 1A is an unseen passage, which is all for 12 marks, 2 marks each. And we have just discussed the types of activities from A1 to A6, which are same as question 1A and same here in the question 2A. So I think there is no need of discussion here. So you all have understood this. We'll move on to the B part, that is summary writing. Now, we are going to have special sessions on writing skills after this. So the details of all the sections, all the questions will be explained in details after this sessions. Summary writing for 3 marks. The question will be in this way. Write a summary of the above extract with a suitable title with the help of the given points, hints, etc. So you have to write the summary of the same passage which is given in question 2A. And some hints will be given to you with the help of which you will be able to write the summary appropriately. This thing we have new this year, mind mapping, which is for 3 marks. And we are also going to have a separate session on this. And in writing skill session, this will be explained in details. The question will be in this way. Develop a mind mapping frame or a design using your ideas, thoughts, concepts to illustrate, develop on a given topic. Just see here, no hints will be given. And as it is a expectation right from your mind, right from your heart, and the question itself is titled as mind mapping, so no hints, no points are given for this. It is for 3 marks. In this way, question 2A plus B plus C, 12 plus 3 plus 3, we have question 2 complete for 18 marks. In this way, this is the end of section 1. Question 2B, let us see the mark scheme of marking, how marks are given. For unseen passage, we have a summary. For the unseen passage, we have 3 marks, and see the distribution of these 3 marks is this. If all points are covered, 1 mark. Language and vocabulary has 1 mark, and grammar overall used by the student has 1 mark. In this way, 3 marks. Scheme of marking for mind mapping, the logical flow of ideas and thoughts and concepts in mind mapping by the student gives him 2 marks. The presentation of all the flow of ideas and presentation in an appropriate way has 1 mark. In this way, the 3 marks are given. So this is the marking scheme. And now we move on to the second section, that is poetry for 14 marks. Here we have 2 types of questions. Poetry and appreciation is the title of the section. And the question is question 3A. Read the extract and complete the activities given below. A scene poem extract will be given from the poems, poetry section for 10 marks. And we have a poem, any poem from the textbook for 10 to 15 lines. And we have this set of questions based on the poem. Again, we have global understanding, inference, personal response, poetic device and creativity. So we are going to have a separate session on creativity and poetic devices. So, and especially poem, we have a separate session on poem. At that point, at that particular session, all these details will be covered. 10 marks we have for scene poem. Let us move on to question 3B, and which is nothing but appreciation. For appreciation, a different poem will be asked, not the same poem. So the first poem will cover the activities and this particular poem will cover the appreciation. So two poems are the must in each question paper. The question will be like this: read the extract and write as per the given instructions. So any scene extract of a poem will be given from which is another poem and not asked in the question 3A part. And you have to write the appreciation. The points will not be given for appreciation because every poem has a different set of points or expectations for a certain appreciation, and therefore this is the reader's own vision of appreciating the poem and the poetry. So question 3A plus B is 10 plus 4 is 14 marks, and this is the end of section 2.